Unlimited.
Secure the X. This is Havana calling.
Secure the X.
This is Radio Havana calling all shortwave listeners and radio amateurs. Welcome to... DXers Unlimited, Radio Havana's weekly feature dedicated to the fascinating world of radio communications.
Hola, amigos, radio aficionados all around the world and in space. You are now listening to a special edition of DXers Unlimited that was recorded in advance of its scheduled airtime because I'm going to be out of town for a few days. So, apologies, because today it will not be possible to provide our high-frequency plus low-band VHF propagation updates and forecasts that you like so much. That, all of you know, had to be prepared as close as possible to the actual airtime of the show. I'm your host, Arnaldo Arnicoro, Radio Amateur CO2KK, and here's item one of this special edition. It is related to a very interesting topic, minimalist low-pass count radios. As our future radio amateurs training program advances at the Plaza and Cerro radio clubs of the city of Havana, the idea is to have every student involved in assembling a shortwave radio, shortwave receiver, so that at the end of the training program, they could go home not only with the knowledge about radio amateur rules and regulations, electronics, basic electronics, antennas, and propagation, as well as the bylaws of our National Amateur Radio Federation, but also they are going to go home with a 40-meter band direct conversion receiver. As a matter of fact, the idea was very well received by the students and the teachers, so now we are gathering and testing the parts to build the prototype. The circuit to be used in the project was designed by a Norwegian radio amateur who passed away at a rather young age while walking in the woods near his home. His family and friends preserved the website of Lima Alpha 8 Alpha Kilo, LA8AK, and it was there where I found this interesting direct conversion receiver circuit, amigos. If you want to see the circuit diagram, just send me an email to inforhc@enet.co. Then slowly and phonetically, inforhc, India, November, Foxtrot, Oscar, Romeo, Hotel Charlie, inforhc, the symbol for at, enet, echo, November, echo, tango, enet, the symbol for period, cu. Now, stay tuned on this same frequency or connected to our World Wide Web Internet streaming audio. I'll be back in a few seconds after a short break for station ID. I'm Arnicoro in Havana. This is Radio Havana Cuba. The name of the show is DXers Unlimited. It's on the air twice weekly. Here is now, for your information, our schedule. DXers Unlimited's weekend edition, the one that you are listening probably now or not, I don't know. Maybe you will be listening to the middle of the week program. Well, the weekend edition is on the air just after the top of the hour Radio Havana Cuba newscast. Remember, the weekend edition just after the Radio Havana Cuba hour, top of the hour newscast. The program is on the air several times all along the Sunday and Monday UTC days. Now, our middle of the week edition is on the air just after the half hour news with the reruns program for Tuesday and Wednesday UTC days. I must add that the scripts of the two shows are totally different and also that both of them include our exclusive and non-copyrighted shortwave propagation updates and forecasts. And now here is our next Radio Hub-related item. It's our program's most popular section, without doubt, and according to your email messages and letters, seems to be the one that you enjoy the most. If now you have questions, and Arnie tries to answer them as soon as possible. Today's question came from South Africa. Listener Ian from Cape Town, South Africa, wants to know why he cannot pick up the trans-equatorial propagation signals on the 10 and 6 meters amateur band at his location. And here is my answer. The areas where the trans-equatorial propagation conditions do happen are now very well defined after many years of observations and research by radio amateurs and professional researchers. It's now quite clear that this type of very unusual propagation mode happens between two belts of very well established areas above and below the Earth's equator. From an analysis of the area covered by those two areas, it seems that the one south of the equator doesn't reach far enough to produce trans-equatorial signals frequently at the QPH, at least as frequently as they happen at more northerly locations like the Republic of Zimbabwe. According to my own personal observations of the trans-equatorial propagation between South America and the Caribbean region, the two belts are evenly distributed above and below the equator, providing radio amateurs and FM broadcast band enthusiasts with unique opportunities to communicate or to pick up FM broadcasts while using very low power and small antennas. Now, here is the second question that I will be answering today here at the DXers Unlimited. It came from Germany, from our longtime amigo Hans Watson. He wants to know what is the typical amateur radio station here in Cuba looks like. So here is my answer. Amigo, the typical Cuban ham radio operator begins his career by fixing and reviving a 2 meter band FM handy topic and connecting it to a homebrew antenna, typically a J-pole made from TV 300 ohms twin lead, and perhaps later adding a 3 to 5 elements homebrew Yagi. The next step in the typical Cuban radio amateur station starting career is trying to pass the second class operator test, the one that will open the possibility of using the high frequency shortwave bands, although still with some limitations. Here in Cuba, the most popular high-frequency band is 40 meters because it provides year-round communications with all of our Cuban archipelago and some nearby areas of other nations. The third phase of the startup, either adapting a professional transceiver, usually removing from a fishing boat, or to actually build a transceiver using whatever parts are locally available. Among the most popular designs of homebrew rigs are the Islander and the Hawaii. The first one, an almost all vacuum tube rig, the hybrid, and the second one, the Hawaii totally solid state double sideband QRP or low power transceiver. Since the last Amateur Radio Federation National Convention, the circuit board for a much more advanced solid state radio have become available at a very reasonable price.